We have a mystery on our hands this week. The scholars are the crew of this mighty ship, the Envisioneer. While in search of an ancient treasure, we were marooned on this island, and a key part of our navigational map went missing. Of the entire crew, we considered four suspects. Today, you will hear the evidence collected against Dr. Smart and Neff, the shipwright.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Honorable Judge Brenda, and I welcome you to our hearing today. In this courtroom, we have a prosecutor, defense attorney, and you, the honorable members of the jury. Presenting the evidence today will be a team of expert medical examiners, engineers, and forensic scientists. The accused, Dr. Leilani Smart, and shipwright Robert Nerf, will now enter their plea. Mr. and Mrs. Defense Attorney, how does your client plead?
My client, Dr. Leilani Smart, pleads not guilty. My client, Robert Nerf, also pleads not guilty, Your Honor.
Your Honor, the evidence that we will present today will, without a doubt, convince you of the guilt of Dr. Leilani Smart and shipwright Robert Nerf. I would like to invite the first group of medical examiners to present their evidence.
We have helped Dr. Smart treat the injured crews of the Envisioneer. Many crew members are injured and has fractures. We used splints and sling to help them with their condition.
We have learned that the crews had different types of fractures that helped us in giving the right treatment.
We followed a standardized approach in examining an injured limb. We also learned about the condition called as the compartment syndrome.
In order to help them, we used the following materials: the splint, the bandage, and the cloth.
First is a splint. This is a SAM splint. It is used to immobilize and limit the movement of the injured limb to avoid further injury or make it worse. We also use a stretchable bandage to secure the splints in place. We also use a triangular cuff to support the splint, especially in the forearm.
The first treatment that we did is the shooter tongue elbow and forearm splint. This is used to aid the forearm and elbow in case of an injury. Charlie and Gabriel will demonstrate how to do this type of splint. This splint is constantly used to immobilize the wrist to avoid too much movement that will cause pain.
The next type of splint that we did was the figure of eight splint. This type of splint is used to immobilize a fractured or sprained ankle or foot. Ankle sprains can be painful. This splint can be applied even if you see no obvious deformity to the bones or the ankle.
Body taping is another splint that we do when there is an injured finger. Body taping is done by taping an injured finger to the adjacent finger. Gauze is used between fingers that will be taped together. The finger adjacent to the injured finger will act as a natural splint.
The last splint that we did was the adjustable neck collar. This is used to help patients that may have neck injuries. This may include neck pain after a fall, any direct force to the neck or any neck pain with numbness, tingling, or weakness in the arms or legs.
The jury will now hear from the engineering specialist.
Good morning, Envisioneers.
We're excited to bring out the news that we're almost done building our robots to go rescue the crew members. We have been working our final touches and are just moments away from going to save them.
These are safer than other robots because we can control them and they won't hurt animals.
As you can see, our teammates are working very hard and doing very, very well.
Are we excited to save the Envisioneers?
Yes!
Perfect. Now, there's a robot to the station. I can see you. Okay.
That's all, folks.
Have a good afternoon.
As you can see, my teammates are building a bridge for our inbox to cross over. The reason we are doing this is because Captain Thomas wanted us to help to get food supply because the food supply is low. We are building bridges out of straws and bending the paper clips in a certain way to make triangles. After we do that, we put the triangles in a foldable bridge, put the paper under the triangles, and we have a just connect them and we have a bridge for two paintings. I mean for our inbox.
As you can see, we have our robot ready to test our big bridge. If we pass the big bridge, we can go pick up food for our crew. If not, we have to try again and do our new.
Camera!
As you can see, this has two batteries because one battery apparently wasn't powerful enough, and one motor and a couple of strings.
There's cobwebs on it. We made cobwebs.
This is the project manager, and this is our teacup ride. And it's called the Cutie Cups, and we wanted to do this because we love teacups.
I'm the designer, and we chose these colors because we couldn't pick this one.
Hi guys, this is a motor, which is to spin this platform.
The theme is colorful, and we used the cardboard as the platform for the teacups and decorated it.
The sea circuits, it's supposed to be a merry-go-round ride.
As you can see, there are four animals on this ride.
There is a motor system that is currently not working at the time, but yeah, it's supposed to make it do that.
It's very colorful to attract people.
The rope wheel in it is a Ferris wheel rope.
You spin it by doing this.
And the reason we called it the rope wheel was because we had this thing start to lean until we hot glued this together so that it would actually be supported by one rope.
We didn't know what the color theme was, so we just used three random colors.
The jury will now hear from the second team of medical examiners.
They found out that there are four species of snakes on the island. The red-tailed green rat snake, the Malayan pit viper, the banded crate, and the king cobra.
When venom attacks your nerves, it will make it difficult for you to speak and make you warm.
The two types of venom are hemotoxic and venomotoxic.
Always remain calm.
Make sure you keep the site of the bite below the hood.
Remove all rings and watches. Call 911.
Walk away from the site slowly.
Do not use a cold compress.
Don't try to capture the snake.
Don't worry.
Don't give alcohol or caffeine.
It's now presenting STEM 5.
Today we dissected a calf heart. Here are some things we learned.
Here are the four chambers of the heart.
The left atrium.
The right atrium.
The left ventricle.
Right, the right ventricle.
The jury will now hear from the blood spatter analysis.
Hi, we are the blood spatter analysts.
We
analyze the blood drops found on the crime scene. Here we created blood samples from different heights, this to determine who the blood belonged to.
As we already know, many of the members have cuts and injuries.
The heights used were 60, 30, and 12 inches.
After creating the scribes, we analyzed each one according to the height. We reached the conclusion that the person responsible, after taking our time and comparing all the blood evidence, Robert Neff.
Shipwright Robert Neff!
The jury will now hear from the forensic scientist.
When we first observed the cornstarch, it had a cloudy-like appearance. The texture was fluffy and the smell smelled like bread. The reaction to vinegar, it just mixed together. No special reactions such as fizzing, bubbling, or solidifying. The reaction to iodine, it hardened and it looked like it's just black crayon straight up.
The mystery powder was lumpy like flour. The appearance was lumpy like flour. The texture was lumpy. The smell was new rubber. The reaction to vinegar was it liquefied, and the reaction to iodine was it melted.
And to conclude, we think that the mystery powder at the scene is cornstarch because the testing reaction was similar and pH levels show this powder mixed with water would help soothe the skin.
So we got a cup with a fingerprint on it, and then we took a brush with cocoa powder and we rubbed it against the cup, which made it more visible to see. And then we took some scotch tape and took the fingerprint off and put it on the book, which made it more so we could see it better. And then we concluded that this one was a fingerprint.
We noticed that the fingerprint matched Dr. Smart's fingerprint more than anyone else's.
We all concluded that Dr. Smart and Robert Neff are guilty.
Young members of the jury, the prosecution rests its case. We will now hear from the defense.
Your Honor, after hearing the concrete evidence of Dr. Layla Smart and Shipwright Robert Neff have decided to change their plea to guilty as charged. They will accept the consequences of their actions and are deeply regretful.
Dr. Leilani Smart and Shipwright Robert Neff has pleaded guilty to their crimes. Members of the jury, you are excused. Congratulations to all of our expert witnesses on a job well done. You are now alumni. Give it up for alumni. Now, so next year, you guys are gonna dissect the brain. You will be building a drone. You're gonna survive a disaster. And there will be a field trip. So see you next year. Bye.